Thank you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May Allah's peace and blessing be upon you all. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. In the name of Allah, the entirely merciful, the specially merciful. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. I bear witness that none has the right to be truly worshipped except Allah. Wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. And I also bear witness that Muhammad is his messenger. Inshallah ta'ala, by the will of Allah, today we will be seeing the meanings of Islam, Iman, and Ihsan. These three are called the level of the religion. The religion of Islam has three levels. They are Islam, Iman, and Ihsan. These three have been derived from the noble and the famous hadith, which is called Hadith Jibril. It's a well-famous hadith narrated by Umar ibn al-Khattab about a stranger, whereby this stranger finally was Jibril, in fact, that he asked Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to explain what is Islam, what is Iman, and what is Ihsan. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained what he knows. And the conclusion is that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked Umar, saying that, do you know who this stranger was? And Umar said that, Allah wa rasuluhu a'lam, Allah and his messenger know best. Then finally, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam confirmed that the stranger who came was Jibril. And his intention of coming, or his main purpose of coming, to teach them the religion. So in this hadith, since Islam was mentioned, Iman was mentioned, and Ihsan was mentioned, that's why we said that the religion of Islam has three levels. Let us see the hadith. The hadith says that, narrated by Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu. He said, بينما نحن جلوس عند رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ذات يوم. One day, while we were sitting with Allah's Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, اطلع علينا رجل. A man suddenly appeared before us. شديد بياض الثياب, wearing a very white dress. شديد سواد الشعر, and having a very black hair. لا يرى عليه أثر السفر, without any sign of a journey upon him. ولا يعرفه منا أحد. And none of us knew him. حتى جلس إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. He approached until he sat before Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. فأسند ركبتيه إلى ركبتيه ووضع كفيه على فخذيه. His knees and the way he sat in front of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was his knees touching the Prophet's knees, and he placed his hands on his thighs. وقال and said, يا محمد أخبرني عن الإسلام. O Muhammad, inform me about Islam. فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Allah's Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, he's going to answer. الإسلام أن تشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمدا رسول الله. The answer of our Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was that Islam is to bear witness that none has the right to be truly worshipped except Allah, and that Muhammad is the Messenger of Allah. This is the first pillar of Islam. وتقيم الصلاة, to offer salat. This is the second pillar. وتؤتي الزكاة, to pay zakah. This is the third pillar. وتصوم رمضان, and to fast the month of Ramadan. This is the fourth pillar of Islam. وتحج البيت إن استطعت إليه سبيلا, and to make Hajj, the pilgrimage to Mecca, if you are able to have the means to make the journey. And this is the fifth pillar of Islam. So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained to the stranger about what is Islam, what it consists of. The first pillar is to bear witness that none has the right to be truly worshipped except Allah, and Muhammad is his messenger. The second one is to offer salah. The third one is to pay zakah. The fourth one is to fast the month of Ramadan. And the fifth one is to make Hajj. The questioner replied, قال صدقت. He said that. The man said, you spoke the truth. Umar said, فَعَجِبْنَا لَهُ يَسْأَلُهُ وَيُصَدِّقُهُ. We were surprised at his asking and confirming at the same time. You know, the person who asks normally will simply take the answer without saying that you are right or you are wrong. This was the normal trend. But the man who simply appeared in front of their face after asking, after Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam responded to him, he said that you have spoken the truth. Then the Sahabas were very surprised. قال, again, the man said, فأخبرني عن الإيمان, inform me about Iman. قال, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, أن تؤمن بالله. Iman is to believe in Allah, وملائكته, his angels, وكتبه, his books, ورسوله His messengers واليوم الآخر To believe in the last day وتؤمن بالقدر And to believe also in the divine preordainment خيره وشره Of all that is good and evil قال صدقت Again the man replied that You have spoken the truth قال Again he said The questioner, the man فأخبرني Tell me عن الإحسان Tell me about إحسان He asked قال The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراك إحسان Perfection is to worship Allah as if you see him If you can't see him surely he sees you قال Again the man, the stranger, the questioner said فأخبرني عن الساعة Inform me about the hour, the doomsday قال ما المسؤول عنها بأعلم من السائل Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said The one asked has no more knowledge of it than the questioner قال Again the questioner asked فأخبرني عن عماراتها He said Inform me about its signs What is the signs of the doomsday قال Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said أن تلد الأمة ربتها وأن ترى الحفاة العراة العالة رعاء الشاء يتطاولون في البنيان Its signs are You know, there are many He's going to explain some of them Its signs are The slave girl will give birth to her mistress And you will see the barefooted, naked, impoverished shepherds Competing with each other in tall buildings Like the one that we saw nowadays They call skyscrapers and so on You know, big tall buildings Those who used to be shepherds You know, barefooted Will come to the cities They will become very rich and they will compete. My building is ground plus this much. Mine is ground plus 15. Mine is having this much. Mine is having this. So they will simply compete. ثم انطلق فلبثت مليا ثم قال لي يا عمر أتدري من السائل؟ قلت الله ورسول أعلم. Then the stranger left. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم remained seated for quite a while. Then he asked me, O Umar, Do you know who the questioner was? I said, Allah and His Messenger know best. قال فإنه جبريل أتاكم يعلمكم دينكم. He صلى الله عليه وسلم said, That was Jibril. He came to teach you your religion. Reported by Imam Muslim. This is the conclusion of the hadith. So, to conclude, so we have finalized today's teaching. By the will of Allah, we will continue step by step. Some other topics like this. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us sincerity in our speech, in our deeds, in our action. And He also give us a good ending. And He also make us from those who inherit Jannat al-Firdaus. May Allah also protect us from shirk, nifaq, bid'ah. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته